Under measurement systems analysis, we have different tools for different occasions. So let's take a look at what we've got here. In measurement systems analysis, we've got gauge R&R and we've got interclass correlation coefficient, which are well suited to data that are collected from things like voltmeters or scales or rulers or digital calipers. We've also got the Kappa tool. The Kappa tool is what you use if you want to know if you can reliably put things back in the same category. A really good example of that is warranty returns. Most companies will look at their warranty returns and make a Pareto chart of them and will assign engineering resources to fix the problems that are found. Well, if those problem categorizations are being generated by a random number generator, then you can very easily misallocate your problem-solving resource. So let's go to Kappa and take a look at that. So we're going to have some samples, and ordinarily we'd like a dozen or so, but this is just a little teaching example, so I'm going to have 5 samples, and you'll see that the grid then immediately expands for 5 samples. Let's just leave this at 4 judges for right now, and let's put things in, let's say 4 categories. Now these categories have to be mutually exclusive, so I can put red, and I can put blue, and I can put yellow, and I can put white. And then I have my judges independently, without any consulting, put things into the category. So I've got 5 samples, and let's just say that all 4 judges agree that the first one is red. And then let's say that all 4 judges agree that the second one is blue. And let's say that they split here. 2 say yellow. 2 say, excuse me, 2 say white. Let's say that this, for some reason, is 4 and 1. And then this one, all 4 will agree again. And then all we have to do is click calculate. And this tells us that we've got not a very good system, but a tolerable system. The rule of thumb is that if your Kappa score is 0.9 or above, you've got a system that works reasonably well. Oh, I made a mistake up here. Look at that. I've got a 1 there. My rows have to add across. And let's see if this changes things a lot. Not very much. Okay. We've got a not very good system, but maybe tolerable. So our gas gauge is up into the yellow. We'd like to see this 0.9 or above. 1 means perfect agreement, and we don't have that here. If it's 0.9 or better, then that would usually indicate that the measurement system doesn't need a lot of improvement. So let's just make this 1 and 3 and see what happens. And that does improve it a bit. And then if I hit delete here and 4 here, then we should get perfect agreement. And we do. So that's a very simple, easy-to-use tool, putting things in categories, looking at the Kappa score.